Friends, welcome back to my channel. Can we replace TL494 with SG3525 or 3525 with 494? It is a question from my viewer. I want to know if we can replace TL494 by SG3525. John from Togo. TL494 and 3525 both are PWM controllers. These are fixed frequency oscillators. These adjust duty cycle. We will compare the functions of both ICs. We will analyze what is here, what is here. Both ICs are 16 pin, but pin function is totally different. Here, pin number 1, pin number 2, non-inverting and inverting inputs. If you see here, here is inverting and non-inverting. Both pins are opposite here. This one is non-inverting, that is positive, but here is inverting. Here is inverting, but here is non-inverting. In TL494, we have two error amplifiers. It have two error amplifier. It have one error amplifier. In TL494, it uses one for voltage adjustment, voltage compensation, and second for current compensation, and sometime it is for temperature compensation. These for regulation purpose. Here it is using just only one error amplifier. Then here is feedback compensation. Here is dead time control, pin number 4. And here is pin number 7 dead time control, that is discharge pin. Then CT pin, timing capacitor pin number 5, timing capacitor pin number 5. RT, timing resistance. Pin number 7, ground. And here ground is at pin number 12. Here is C1, collector number 1, collector number 2, emitter number 1, emitter number 2. But here pin configuration is different. Pin number 9, here compensation. Here pin number 3 is compensation. Then we have shutdown pin here, output A, ground, VC, collector voltage, output B, V reference, output control, then inverting and non-inverting inputs. Output section of this IC, it is open collector based. But here, it is using totem pole. In open collector, we have this transistor here. The internal circuit will drive its base. If we provide positive voltage here, and we can take switched positive voltage in this shape, when it will turn on, these positive voltage will come outside. But if we connect emitter to ground and we take output from here, then we will take inverted output. But in SG3525, it is using totem pole, that is configuration of two transistors. It will provide just only this pulse. When its internal flip-flop will turn on, it will provide this output. Here we are free. We can use any type of output pulse. Either it is positive going or negative going. But here, we will use this pulse. If we are using SG3527, at that time, in case of 27, the pulse will, in turn on time, it will go to low. Frequency range, it is up to 300 kHz. And it is up to 400 kHz. 100 Hz to 400, 100 Hz to 300 kHz. So, output stage is different. Then the supply voltage, it is from 7 to 42 volt, and it is 8 volt to 40 volt. So we can say the voltage range is similar. Then for oscillator, here it is using RT and CT. Here is oscillator RT and CT, but in this IC there is an additional component, that is discharge pin, that is pin number 7. So pin number 7, that is used to produce dead time control. And here is error amplifier for voltage setting or for current setting. This IC is most commonly used in welding machines where we need very high current. This IC is used in most of the power supplies for push-pull configuration. Then facility in this IC that it can be used in both modes, single-ended, double-ended. Single-ended, when the output control pin number 13 is connected to ground, at that time its both transistors will work as a one transistor, so both circuits will switch together. So at that time it will work as a one switch. At that time its output frequency will same as the oscillator frequency. If pin number 13 is connected to reference voltage 5 volt, at that time this IC will start in push-pull, double-ended operation. Both transistors will work opposite to each other. So we can use this IC as a push-pull. We can say two MOSFET drive. If pin 13 is grounded, it will drive one transistor. But at that time, its drive current will increase. But here, SG3525, it will drive only push-pull. We can say it will drive two MOSFETs. It can drive single or it can drive double. Reference voltage are same. 5 volt, 5 volt. If you compare the pinout of both ICs, at that time we cannot replace these ICs. And if we check the function of both output stages, at that time we cannot replace, because this have open collector output and this have totem pole output. But if we rearrange circuit using data sheet, and if we compromise one error amplifier and we just only control voltage, or we are going to monitor the current, at that time we can rearrange the circuit to use this IC in place of this. But it is best practice to use TL494 or KA7500, because TL494 or KA7500, these are the same. Both ICs have dead time control. If we are using this IC in double ended and we rearrange the circuit, this IC to drive double ended operation, at that time we can configure it. Maybe at that time we need a very careful study about error amplifier and compensation. If this video is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.